नॉन लीनियर पार्शियल डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशंस। ये पार्शियल डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विच इन्वॉल्व्स फर्स्ट ऑर्डर पार्शियल डेरिवेटिव्स पी एंड क्यू विथ डिग्री हायर देन वन एंड the products of P and Q is called the non-linear partial differential equation of first order. In practice, there are six types of nonlinear partial differential equations of first order as given below. So linear partial differential equation in the previous classes we discussed. We clearly given the definition of linear partial differential equation. Linear means so an equation which involves only the first order derivatives P and Q with degree 1 only and not multiplied together P and Q. Such type of equations are known as linear partial differential equation. Now here we are discussing non-linear partial differential equations. Non-linear means degree is more than 1. That means the first order partial derivatives P and Q must involve with a degree higher than 1 and products can also involve, products of P and Q can also involve. Such a type of equations are known as non-linear partial differential equations of first order. Since it is a first order, why it is a first order means P and Q are partial derivatives of first order. So it is called non-linear partial differential equation of first order. But in practice, there are six types of linear, non-linear partial differential equations of first order. Now we discuss what are the types of non-linear partial differential equations. Number one, first, f of p comma q is equal to 0. Second one, z is equal to px plus qy plus f of p comma q. Third one, f of z comma p comma q is equal to 0. Fourth one, f1 of x comma p is equal to f2 of वाई कामा क्यू. फिफ्थ वन, एफ ऑफ एक्स पावर एम इंटू पी कामा वाई पावर एन इंटू क्यू इज इक्वल टू जीरो एंड एफ ऑफ जेड कामा एक्स पावर एम इंटू पी कामा एक्स पावर एन इंटू क्यू इज इक्वल टू जीरो. सिक्स वन, एफ ऑफ जेड पावर एम इंटू पी कामा जेड पावर एम इंटू क्यू इज इक्वल टू जीरो एंड एफ एन ऑफ एक्स कामा जेड पावर एम इंटू पी इज इक्वल टू एफ टू ऑफ वाई कामा जेड पावर एम इंटू क्यू. दीज आर दी सिक्स टाइप्स ऑफ नॉन लीनियर पार्शियल डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन ऑफ फर्स्ट ऑर्डर. Now let us discuss how to solve the non-linear partial differential equations of first order one by one in detail. Now first type 1. Type 1 is an equation of the form f of pq is equal to 0. Here there is no x, y and z terms, only p and q terms involved. So this type of equation can be represented by f of pq is equal to 0. This can be treated as a type 1. Type 1 equations is of the form or of the form f of p comma q equal to 0. In this type, we are having only p and q and there is no x, y and z. To solve this type of equations, let us assume that z is equal to ax plus by plus c be the solution of the given equation. And then proceed as in the following examples. To solve this type of equations, f of pq is equal to 0. Here I already explained there is no x, y and z. Only it involves p comma q. So the combination of p and q occurs in this type of equations. To solve this type of equations, here we assume that z is equal to ax plus by plus c be the solution of the given equation. There is a proof how it will become a solution for this type of equations, but so no need to prove the how z equal to ax plus by plus c becomes a solution for this type of equations. It is enough to remember z is equal to ax plus by plus c be the solution of the given equation. And how to proceed further we can show as in the following examples. Now example number 1, problem number 1 or example number 1, solve p square plus q square is equal to 4. Now write down the given equation. this is of the form f of pq is equal to 0. Given that p square plus q square is equal to 4. If you can write 4 in the left hand side, p square plus q square minus 4 equal to 0. Therefore, this is of the form f of pq is equal to 0. Say this is equation number 1. As explained in the procedure, let us assume that z is equal to ax plus by plus c be the solution of the given equation. So this is of the form f of p comma q is equal to 0. Therefore, let z is equal to ax plus by plus c, say this is equation number 2, be the solution of the given equation 1, be the solution of the given equation 1. Now, partially differentiating equation 2 with respect to x and y respectively. Now, partially differentiating equation 2 with respect to x and y respectively. Now, partially differentiating with respect to x, dou z by dou x, partially differentiating with respect to x. So a into derivative of x is 1. Partial derivative with respect to x means y is a 0. Derivative of y is 0 since y is a constant. Except x, other variables are being constants. Sorry. Therefore, 0. C is a constant. Therefore, this is also 0. Therefore, dou z by dou x, in the beginning of this chapter, we explained that we use the following notations. That means dou z by dou x is equal to p, dou z by dou y is equal to q. So, therefore, this can be written as p is equal to a. P is equal to a. Next, again, partially differentiating z with respect to y, keeping x as a constant. Now dou z by dou y is equal to a into x. A is a constant, x is a constant, 0. B into y, b is a constant, derivative of y is 1. C is a constant, derivative is 0. Therefore, 0 plus b into 1 plus 0. Therefore, dou z by dou y is denoted by q is equal to b. Therefore, q is equal to b. Substituting the values of p and q in equation number 2. The values of a and b in equation 2, we get equation 2 is z is equal to ax plus by plus c, but a equal to p, b is equal to q. Therefore, z is equal to px plus qy. Sorry. Substituting the values of p and q in equation number 1. Therefore, equation 1 is p square plus q square is equal to 4. P square plus q square is equal to 4. P square value is a square plus q square value b square is equal to 4. This is the relation between A and B. Therefore, from this, we can find the value of B. B square is equal to 4 minus A square. Therefore, B is equal to plus or minus square root of 4 minus A square. Substituting the value of B in equation number 2. Substituting value of B in equation 2, that is solution of given equation of the type f of pq, that is z is equal to ax plus by plus c. Now we are substituting the value of B is equal to plus or minus square root of 4 minus a square. Therefore, z is equal to a into x plus or minus square root of 4 minus a square into y plus constant of integration. Therefore, which is the complete solution or complete integral of the given equation 1. Complete integral means as it contains two arbitrary constants A and C, two independent variables X and Y. If the number of arbitrary constants is equal to number of independent variables, then the solution is called complete integral. In the solution, if the number of independent variables is equal to number of arbitrary constants, then it is called complete integral. So you can write what is complete integral. So complete integral means complete integral the number of independent variables is equal to the number of arbitrary constants. Arbitrary constants in the solution. You just remember what is complete integral. The number of independent variables is equal to number of independent variables. Then it is called complete integral. Another problem number 2. Solve square root of p plus square root of q is equal to 1. First write down the given equation. Given that square root of p plus square root of q is equal to 1. 1 can be written in the left hand side. Therefore, square root of p plus square root of q minus 1 equal to 0. Therefore, this is of the form f of pq equal to 0. Say this is equation number 1. As explained in the procedure, let z is equal to ax plus by plus c, say equation 2, be the solution of the given non-linear partial differential equation 1. Therefore, now partially differentiating equation 2 with respect to x and y respectively. X and y respectively. Now dou z by dou x, as in the previous problem, here also we can get a into 1 plus 0 plus 0. Therefore, p is equal to a. Now dou z by dou y is equal to a into 0 plus b into 1 plus 0, 0 plus b into 1 plus 0. Therefore, q is equal to b. Substituting the values of p and q in equation number 1 as in the previous problem. Therefore, substituting the values of p and q in equation number 1, we get square root. A given equation is square root of p plus square root of q is equal to 1. Then square root of a plus square root of b is equal to 1. Therefore, that implies square root of b is equal to 1 minus square root of a. Squaring on both sides, square root of b whole square is equal to, b, 1 minus square root of a whole square. Therefore, b is equal to square root of, 1 minus a root a whole square. Now, substituting the value of b in equation 2, then substituting the values of b in equation 2, we get equation 2 is z is equal to ax plus by plus c. We are substituting b is equal to 1 minus square root of a whole square. Therefore, z is equal to ax plus b 1 minus square root of a whole square plus c. Therefore, as it contains two arbitrary constants a and c and two independent variables, therefore this solution is called complete integral. Complete integral, which is the complete integral of the given partial differential equation. I explained in the previous problem why it is called complete integral, as it contains two independent variables and two arbitrary constant. These two are equal in number, therefore such type of solutions are known as complete integral. Ax plus 1 minus root a whole square into y plus c. Solve fourth one. Solve PQ plus P plus Q is equal to 0. Solution. First, write down the given equation. Given that p plus q equal to 0. This is of the form f of p p comma q equal to 0, as there is no x, y and z, only p and q terms involved here. Therefore, this is of the form f of p comma q equal to 0. As explained in the procedure, let z is equal to ax plus by plus c. Say this is equation number 1, this is equation number 2, be the solution of the given equation 1. Solution of the given equation 1. Therefore, now partially differentiating equation 1, sorry, equation 2 with respect to x and y respectively. Therefore, dou z by dou x is equal to here a into 1 plus 0 plus 0. Therefore, that implies p is equal to a. Now, partially differentiating with respect to y, that is dou z by dou y. Now, x is constant 0 plus b plus 0. Therefore, q is equal to b. Now, substituting the values of p and q in equation number 1. The values of p and q in equation 1, we get z is equal, sorry, first equation number 1, pq plus p plus q, substitute p equal to a, q equal to b, p equal to a, q equal to b, that means ab plus a plus b equal to 0. AB plus A plus B is equal to 0. Therefore, this can be simplified as B is a common factor. A plus 1 plus A equal to 0. Therefore, from this, B into A plus 1 is equal to minus A. Therefore, from this b is equal to minus a by a plus 1. This is the value of b. We are writing the value of b in terms of a, or you can write a in terms of b, there is no problem. So to reduce the number of arbitrary constants involved in the assumed solution z is equal to ax plus by plus c, and this solution to be complete integral. So we are reducing the number of arbitrary constants in the solution. Therefore, substituting the value of b in equation number 2, we get equation number 2 is z is equal to ax plus by plus c. Here we have to substitute b is equal to minus a by a plus 1. Therefore, z is equal to a into x plus b, b value minus a by a plus 1 into y plus c. Here, if you can see here, the number of arbitrary constants a and c, the number of independent variables are x and y. So therefore, two independent variables is equal to two arbitrary constants. Therefore, this is the complete integral, which is the complete integral of the given equation 1. Next problem number 4. Problem number 4. Solve 3 into p square minus 2 into q square is equal to 4 into pq. Write down the given equation. Given that three p square two q square is equal to 4 into pq. Say this is equation number 1. This is of the form f of p comma q is equal to 0. Therefore, as explained in the solution, let z is equal to ax plus by plus c, say this is equation number 2, be the solution of the given equation 1. Now, partially differentiating equation 2 with respect to x and y respectively. Now dou z by dou x, as explained in the previous 3 problems, this is a into 1 plus 0 plus 0. Therefore, that implies p is equal to a. Similarly, q is also is equal to b. Now dou z by dou y is equal to a into 0 plus b into 1 plus c into, that means 0, b into 1, 0 plus b into 1 plus 0. Therefore, q is equal to b. Substituting the values of p and q in equation number 1, we are writing the same similar steps in all the problems. You clearly observe that the substituting the values of p and q in equation number 1, that means given equation. So equation 1 is a square minus 2q square is equal to 4q pq. Therefore, 3 into a square minus 2 into b square is equal to 4 into ab. 3 into a square minus 2 into b square is equal to 4 into ab. Therefore, this can be written as 2b square plus 4ab minus 3a square equal to 0. We are writing 3a square and minus 2b square in the another side, that is right hand side. So this minus sign becomes plus sign, plus sign becomes a minus sign. 0 is equal to this one, but I am writing 2b square plus 4ab minus 3a square is equal to 0. Therefore, which is a quadratic equation in B. Which is a quadratic equation in B. So therefore, say comparing, this is a x square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Here, which is a quadratic equation, equation in small b. Instead of x, we are taking b. Since to find the value of b, we are considering this equation as a quadratic equation in B, if you want to find the value of A, you can consider this equation as a quadratic equation in A also. So here I would like to find the value of B. So I can consider this equation as a quadratic equation in B. Therefore, comparing this equation with the standard form Ax square plus Bx plus C, here X is B. So A is 2. Here A is equal to 2. B is equal to 4a and C is equal to minus 3a square and X is equal to B. Therefore, B is equal to formula X is equal to minus B plus or minus square root of B square minus 4ac by 2 into A. Here we use this formula for the given equation. Instead of X here, B, B is equal to minus capital B minus 4a plus or minus square root of capital B square 16a square minus 4a into C. A is 2, 4 into 2, 8. C is minus 3, minus into minus plus 8 into 3, 24. A square, therefore by 2 into capital A, 2 into 2, 4. Therefore, this is minus 4A plus or minus 16 plus 24, 40 A square. This is equal to minus 4A plus or minus 40 A square by 4. This is equal to minus 4A by 4 plus or minus 40 can be written as 4 into 10 a square by 4, that is equal to minus 4 4 cancel, a plus or minus 4 can be written as square root of 4 is 2, root 10 square root of a square is a by 4, 2 1s 2 2s. Therefore minus a plus or minus square root of 10 by 2 into A. This is a B. Substituting the value of B in equation number 2, that is solution of the given equation. Now substituting the value of B in equation 2, we get equation 2 is z is equal to ax plus by plus c. Now substitute the value of b here. Z is equal to a into x plus b value minus a plus or minus square root of 10 by 2a into y plus c. You can also take out a as a common factor here. Therefore, ax plus a into minus 1 plus or minus square root of 10 by 2 into y plus c, which is the complete integral of the given equation. As it contains two independent variables x and y and two arbitrary constants a and b, which is the complete integral of the given equation. Problem number 5. Solve p square q square is equal to n square. solution. Write down the given equation. Given that p square plus q square equal to n square. This is of the form f of p comma q equal to 0. If you can write p square plus q square minus n square equal to 0, this is of the form f of p q equal to 0. There is no x, y, z, only p and q involves here. Therefore, let z is equal to ax plus by plus c. Say this is equation number 1, this is equation number 2, be the solution of given equation. Therefore, partially differentiating equation 2 with respect to x and y respectively. Therefore, dou z by dou x is equal to A. That implies P is equal to A. As explained in the previous problems, other B into Y, C becomes 0. Dou z by dou y is equal to B. Since the derivative of AX is 0, B into 1 plus 0. Therefore, Q is equal to B. Substituting the values of P and Q in equation number 1. Now substituting the values of P and Q in equation 1. We get equation 1 is p square plus q square is equal to n square. Here we are substituting a square plus b square is equal to n square. A square plus b square is equal to n square. Therefore, b square is equal to n square minus a square. B is equal to plus or minus square root of n square minus a square. Now substituting this value of b in equation number 2 to find the complete integral. Now substituting the value of b in equation 2, we get equation 2 is z is equal to ax plus by plus c. Ax plus by plus c. Write down ax plus b value plus or minus square root of n square minus a square. Square root of n square minus a square into y plus c. Therefore, it contains only two arbitrary constants, a and c, and two independent variables, x and y. Therefore, number of arbitrary constants is equal to number of independent variables. Therefore, this is complete integral, which is the complete given equation. One.